Stephen Hawking was a British cosmologist and physicist, most famously known for his scientific works regarding the theoretical prediction of radiation emission from black holes, Hawking radiation, Penrose-Hawking theorems, the general theory of relativity, and quantum mechanics. He also authored A Brief History of Time, a popular bestseller that discusses the Big Bang and black holes. Apart from these accomplishments, there's another rather unfortunate thing he was known for: his condition of amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, commonly known as ALS. Referred to as motor neuron disease in some countries, it involves the death of neurons in a patient's brain. It results in muscle twitching and a gradual deterioration of muscles, which leads to difficulty swallowing, speaking, and eventually breathing. Therefore, Hawking used a number of gadgets to continue giving lectures and communicate with people, since he no longer had the ability to speak as most people do. Let's check out some different parts of this machinery and explore how they helped Hawking disseminate his brilliance to the world. What Hawking used to communicate is named a speech-generating device, SGD, or a voice output communication aid. This is a special device that either supplements or replaces speech and writing for those who have problems communicating in a traditional way. Hawking used this computer-based communication system, made by Intel Corporation, from 1997 until his passing in 2018. The entire computer system was replaced every 2 years to cope with his gradual loss of muscle control over time. His communication system had three major components. First was the input, which also happened to be the most challenging element in Hawking's case. Like many other ALS patients, he had little control over his muscles, so he couldn't just type out words or click some buttons to input the information. He required a different, more sophisticated way to feed information into the computer. This was achieved by an infrared switch mounted on his spectacles that caught the slightest twitches or movements in his cheek. Before his condition worsened, he would press a clicker using his thumb for input. However, he eventually lost control of the nerves that controlled his thumb and had to use other methods of input, hence the infrared switch that tracked movements in his cheek. The next part involves forming words using the input from the infrared switch. This interface is a program called Easy Keys. It provides a software keyboard displayed on a tablet computer and mounted on one arm of his wheelchair. The software moves a cursor across the keyboard by moving through columns or rows. When it reaches the desired word, Hawking could stop it with a twitch of his cheek. Individual letters were selected in this way to form words and then sentences. The software also included an autocomplete feature, like what we have in smartphones and tablets, that predicted the word without requiring Hawking to complete the entire spelling. The last and easiest part is vocalizing the sentence out loud. For this, Hawking used a speech synthesizer that spoke the sentence once it had been approved or completed. This machine also allowed him to do many other tasks too, including checking his mail, browsing the internet, making notes, and using Skype to chat with friends. With these tools, Hawking could give lectures and interact with people without much difficulty and continue educating the world. If you enjoyed this video, we'd love to hear from you in the comments section. Your feedback not only supports us, but also helps our channel reach more viewers and continue to grow.